he could be born with this artery narrowed. And so as a child, what happens is you present with hypertension. And you may be present with a little bit of hypokalemia. Might be missed, because we have a tendency to ignore hypertension. But in adults, you find it by the fact that they're hypertensive, they're hypokalemic, they have metabolic alkalosis, and you can usually hear a brewery over their abdomen. You can hear the blood being forced through this stricture, psh, 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 with a brewery over their belly. So every time you see someone with hypertension, you have to listen to their belly to see if they have this brewery. It's a leading cause of secondary hypertension.
Did y'all get that at all in cardiology?
You guys did. Yes, the problem with it is you can be born with it because it's genetically determined, or you can develop it as an atherosclerotic lesion.
Right, and there's in here, though. I wouldn't talk about renal artery embolism and
yeah, he's still lecturing.
But he is the information I wanted you all to present. So I actually have a slide from last year that I will give to you all. I'll present after you meet with Dr. Bennett this afternoon, because those are important. The stenosis and stuff like that are important.
The thing that's most important about them is that they can cause elevated blood pressure, and then they can cause metabolic alkalosis and hypokalemia. Something's not perfusing the kidney quite well.
When I'm in internal medicine, I have all these people with uncontrolled hypertension, and I don't know how many renal ultrasounds I ordered. I never got a renal artery stenosis.
Yeah.
I didn't think even one. Or I found one lady, I was doing it, and they found that she actually had an enlargement of her aorta. So that was found incidentally. I wasn't even looking for that. Yeah. So then she had, an abdominal aneurysm, so I had to send her to a cardiologist to have that monitored anyway.
Well, I think that's true in any general internal medicine practice, that patient has severe hypertension, you're having trouble getting it under control, and so you ultrasound their renal arteries, you find this renal artery stenosis. The problem is, what do you do about it? Because an operation is a huge operation. That's a big time retroperitoneal operation, to put a stent in there or something. Angioplasty doesn't work very well. We used to angioplasty them all, but then they all came back, or the kidney quit working. So most people now, when the patient has severe hypertension, if you're looking for secondary hypertension, you go ahead and look for that. But the problem is blood pressure. You just keep putting on more blood pressure medicine until you get the pressure down.
Right.
Already
checked for
Theo's.
I've never done a
Theo either. Yeah, Theo Cronus, I
told him. So I'm sorry, so I'll have to lecture a little bit. It won't take very long. There's like four topics after Dr. Mineta does it this afternoon. But I just want to make sure you all have that information, because that's what I asked him to talk about. But he's actually talking about giant cell arteritis and all the vasculitis that he was talking about today.
Yeah, we did that.
But then he'll talk today, you'll hear again this afternoon, so it'll help us.
Okay. Well, that'd be like twice as many questions on the topic material, or will you pull,
I'll probably pull from both of their lectures.
How many questions do you want from this? Okay. Yeah. 16. Huh?
16?
What do you think?
No, I'm sorry. 8 to 10.
8 to 10.
Yeah.
All right.
I think
I can give you 10.
Okay. Can we get those as well before the test? It's like practice.
It's like practice.
I think I've already written 7 questions, and I think I emphasized pretty well in the lecture. What I'm most worried about, you knowing.
And yes, and if you notice, the PKD lecture is on a PDF, and it was sent to me that way.
Anybody fast?
Yeah,
just make it.
Yeah, I'm sure that's what we want. So if he comes this afternoon with a PowerPoint.
of Wayne Hall of Wayne to D2L. But that's all be different, this secondary was close to you, so. See y'all back at 1, 3 a.m.
Is it going?